is because the samskaras of snake are there. If there is somebody who has never seen a snake, never heard of the snake, he won't see a snake in the place of oak. He may see something like a mala, he may see a garland or something like that, but not a snake. So therefore, whatever the mind projects must have a basis in the samskaras that the mind has, and that samskara, those samskaras which are gathered from the experiences. So this is the our siddhanta about the dream, that swapna is mithya. That because it is what we find out when we wake up, and therefore it is the projection of the mind. And the projection of the mind is always based on the knowledge that the mind has. It cannot be outside the boundary of the knowledge. That's why it is na cha swapno nama apurvam darshanam. Therefore, in swapna, you cannot see something that is never experienced or that has no basis in experience at all. So that swapna cannot be such as that. Then, purva drushta smritirhi swapna prayana. Purva drushta smritirhi swapna. What is swapna? Purva drushta smritirhi. Smriti means the remembrance of what has been seen earlier. That is usually prayana. Usually dream pertains to the remembrance of the based on samskaras of what you have experienced in the past. And this is swapna dhiya bhavi janma bhavi nopi swapna darshanat prayana iti uktam. Swapna dhiya bhavi janma bhavi nopi. Footnote number 6. Bhavi janmani bhavishyatah vastunah vi swapna darshanat. So since by the swapna dhi, by the mind in the dream, since you also see things that are going to happen in the future birth, therefore prayana purva drushta smritihi. Usually what you see in the dream is based on the remembrance or memory of what you experienced in the past. There are occasions when you might even see what is going to come in the next birth. It's possible. Now Anandagiri says, Nacha tada purva darshanapi samyajnanam utthana pratyaya badhat. Nacha tada purva darshanapi. Footnote number 7. Nanu swapnasya smriti rupatve tatratyarthanam pratyakshopalabdhi nasyadhyah nacha tadapurva. See, Vashyakara said, purva drushta smriti hi swapna prayana. It is smriti. It is a recollection of what has been seen in the past. That is what happens in the dream. And so the footnote number 7 says, Nanu swapnasya smriti rupatve. If you say that the dream is of the nature of smriti or the memory, tatratyarthanam pratyaksha upalabdhinasyad, then there is no pratyaksha. Then you cannot call swapna as a pratyaksham. See, the swapna is presented here as a pratyaksha. So pratyaksha, swapna pratyaksha, it is presented here as a direct experience of the events of the next birth. If you say that swapna is merely a smriti, smriti is memory. Memory always pertains to experience at other time, whereas pratyaksha is experience of what is at this time. So pratyaksha is a pramanam, but memory may not be accepted as pramanam. Some people accept it as pramanam, but some people do not accept memory as an evidence, because there can be an error also committed, or there can be vagueness, or there can be some change in pratyaksha that cannot be. So nanu svapnasya smriti rupatve tatratyarthanam pratyaksha upalabdhinasyat. Then tatratyarthanam, meaning the objects obtained in the dream, you cannot call it the perception of those objects, because it is merely memory. Itataha nacha tadapurvadi. So Anandagiri says, nacha tadapurva darshanapi. Then again the Tika says, tathacha shukti rupyadi jnanavat apurvatvevi samskara janyatva anugamad smritulyatvabhiprayana smrititvabhidhanam iti bhavah. Is not quite smriti, but like smriti. Tathaja shukti rupyadi jnanavat. Like one sees silver where there is a mother of pearl, or one sees a snake where there is a rope. And I said that also, purvatrevi samskara janyatvat. One can see the silver only when the samskaras of silver are there in the mind. One can see the snake if the samskaras of snake are there in the mind. Tathaja shukti rupyati jnanavat apurvatrevi samskara janyatva anugamat. So apurvam, something new also can be born of the samskara. Like this, like the silver, which is not there, and that silver darshanam is there because of samskara. Shruti tulyatva vibhrayana shrutitva vidhanam. That sapna is not quite the smruti. Sapna is a projection. But just as you project that silver, or just as you project that snake, so in the projection of the silver on the mother of pearl, or projection of snake on the rope, smruti is involved, the past samskaras are involved. As we said that, unless you had the samskara of the snake, you could not have seen the snake there. In the memory also past samskara is involved. In that sense, the word smruti is used by Bhashyakara. That is, a dream is not to be stated as smruti. Dream is a projection. Apurva darshan. There you see something which you have never seen in the waking, etc. But at the same time, that darshanam is based on the samskaras of the experiences gained. But it is not purely memory. It is projection. So, smruti tulyatva vibhrayana. In memory also the past samskaras are required. In the projection also past samskaras are required. In that sense, this projection, the dream, was said to be memory. But actually, smruti tulyatva vibhrayana, smrutitva vidhanam iti bhavah. Then footnote number 8 says, tad apurva darshanam iti astu va svapna darshanam apurvam. All right. Let us say that what you experience in the dream is unique to the dream. Tathapi na tat prama. Then also it is not prama. It is brahma, but not prama. It is not valid knowledge. Tat rahetu utthana ityadihi. So go back to Anandagiri now. Nacha tad apurva darshanapi samyak jnanam or prama. In the dream also, the apurva darshan that you have can be said to be sammijnana, meaning the true knowledge or prama. Uttana pratyabhadhat. Because when you wake up, then the whole dream is dismissed as is negated, as false. And therefore, you cannot say that what you experience in the dream is real. That means, is the true knowledge. So that's what footnote number 8 said. Astuva svapna darshanam apurvam. Tathapi na tat prama tatra hetu utthana ityadi bhrantescha samskara janyatva niyamat siddham bhut janma iti bhavah. So smruti also is samskara janya and bhranti also is samskara janya. So smruti also requires the samskara of the past, bhranti also requires the samskara of the past. Therefore, swapna is bhranti, which is samskara janya bhranti. Tasma siddham bhut janma. And therefore, if you see in the dream something that is never experienced so far, then we have to say that the samskara of that experience was there in the mind anyway, and that proves that there is a past birth. From which, because if you say that drushta smruti, if the dream is a smruti, a dream is based on the samskara of what is already experienced, and if what you see in the dream is not seen to be experienced in this life, then we have to say that that experience of the dream is due to the samskaras carried on from the previous life. And that's how bhut janma iti siddham, therefore the past birth is very established. Then Anandagiri says, nacha evam svapna dhiya bhavi janma asiddhihi. Footnote number 9. Svapna darshanasya mithyatve. But hey, svapna darshanam is mithya. If that darshan is mithya, then the objects are also mithya. See, svapna objects are mithya and svapna jnanam also is mithya. If svapna jnanam is mithya, how can you say that by the mithya jnanam in the svapna that you can establish the existence of the other birth? So that other birth is real and the svapna jnanam is mithya. How can mithya jnanam establish the existence of a real thing? Now, you are presenting here svapna protection as evidence for the previous birth or the next birth. But if the svapna knowledge in the svapna is mithya, How can that mithya jnanam establish the existence of real things, such as past birth or present birth? How can swapna protection be presented as an evidence of pramanam for the establishment of the existence of other birth? Because that whole thing is mithya.
So it is said, nacha evam swapna dhya bhavi janma asiddhihi.
Just because these objects of the dream are mithya, knowledge also is mithya, you cannot say that bhavi janma or bhuta janma is not there.
Yatha jnanam arthangi karadi bhavah. Yatha jnanam arthangi karad.
That in keeping with the knowledge, the earth is there. See footnote number 10.
Yatha jnanam arthangi karadi bhavah. Tatha cha swapne jnanavat arthasya mithyatve bhi. Tatsujitasya samyaktvena siddhatyevam bhavi janma iti bhavah.
Tathaj svapne jnanava darthasya mithyatve bhi. So similar, just so therefore, in the dream, just as the knowledge is mithya, so the objects of dream are also mithya, tathabhi. Tat suchitasya. But at least it suggests something. So the pleasure and pain that experience the dream, they may not be exactly the pleasure and pain of the next birth, but at least they definitely give evidence of the next birth.
Samyaktena siddhyateva iti bhavi janma iti bhava.
Uktam hi, the footnote says, suchakaschahi shrutehe achakshadeja tadvidaha. Suchakascha. Suchaka means it's an indicator. Shrutehe, because Shruti says that. In the Chandogya Upanishad, the Shruti says how certain dreams give the indication of certain events that are going to happen.
Achakshadeja tadvidaha.
Those people who are well versed in the dream, they also tell us that when you see certain things in the dream, so, suchakasyahi shrutehe, svapne jayamanas tridarshanadi. What happens is when you are performing certain rituals for a certain result. Suppose that you are performing a ritual so that my son should have a male child, let us say, whatever. Suppose such a thing is being performed. Or that such and such disease should be cured. Or that I should have such and such thing too. I want to acquire such and such thing. So with this kind of a desire, suppose you are performing a ritual, which is meant to give that result. So maybe that ritual lasts for several days. In the midst of that, suppose you have a dream where you see a person in the white. If that dream is there, then you know that your ritual is going to be successful. So the person that you saw, that in the white, is false, is mithya. But the suchikam, what he indicates, namely the success of the ritual, is true. So what you see is mithya, but what it indicates is true. Or they say that if you see in the dream a black woman with black teeth, or a black man with black teeth. Now, in the dream you see a woman in white, then you know that your ritual is going to be successful. If in the dream you see a black man with black teeth, then you know that he's going to cause you death. So like this, many things are there. So depending upon, so tadvidaha, there are those who are experts in interpreting the dreams, and they can tell you what event will happen. So even though what you saw in the dream is mithya, and the seeing also is mithya, but suchakaha, what it indicates is true. Similarly also, if you experience something that pertains to past birth or the future birth, then it may not be exactly what will experience the past birth or what will be experienced the future birth, but definitely it suggests the existence of past birth or existence of future birth. That is true. So what it suggests is real. That means it suggests that the past birth is real or the future birth is real. In that sense, Swapna Pratyaksha becomes the evidence for establishing the existence of the other birth.
So Anandagiri said, yatha jnanam arthangi karadi bhavah.
Then see, yathang tas suchitasya samyaktvena siddhyati. So what it indicates is true, and therefore
the past and the previous and the later birth are established here. Pramana phalam upasamharati. Now Bhashyakara concludes the pramana phalam. What is pramana phalam? How swapna pratyaksham establishes the existence of the next birth, upasamharati tena iti. Tena swapna jagrata sthana vyatirekena staha ubhau lokau. Tena, what is tena? That is footnote number 3. Paraloka sadbhave swapna pratyakshasva manatvena. Since swapna pratyaksham becomes a pramanam for the existence or establishing existence of paraloka, therefore, swapna jagarasthana vitarekena ubho loka ustaha. Therefore, we have to say that there are two worlds other than the swapna and jagarita. The two worlds are not merely swapna and jagarita, but there are two worlds in the form of this birth and next birth, which are other than the swapna jagrita. They are. And for that, swapna pratyaksha becomes the pramana. And so this part of the passage is interpreted by Bhashyakara as establishing existence of ihaloka and paraloka, because sahastamanasan ubholoko anusancharati. In identification of the buddhi, he travels between this world and the next, this birth and the next. So that part of the passage is explained here. And then the other two will be explained in the subsequent part of the passage. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punaha. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. 1046. Tasya va etasya purushasya dve eva sthane bhavatah. Idam cha paraloka sthanam cha. Sandhyam trutiyam. Svapna sthanam. Tasmin sandhyam tasmin sandhye sthane tishthan. Ete ubhe sthane pashyati. Idam cha paraloka sthanam cha. Atha yatha kramoyam paraloka sthane bhavati. Tamakramam akramya. Ubhayan papmana anandam sipasyade. Sayatra prasvavide. Asya lokasya sarvavato matram apadaya. Svayam vihatya, svayam nirmaya, svena bhasa, svena jyotisha, prasvapide, atrayam purusha svayam jyotir bhavati. Tasya vai tasya purushasya dve avasthane bhavatah idam cha paralokasthanam cha. So of this Purusha, of this Self, Tveva Sthane Bhavataha, he has only two sthana, two abodes, Idam cha Paraloka Sthanam cha,
this as well as the other world, meaning this birth and the other births, this birth and the other birth.
Sandhyam tritiyam swapnasthanam,
whereas dream is a sandhi, is a junction of these two, this world and the next world.
Tasmin sandhye sthane tishthan ete uhe sthane pashyati,
remaining or being there in that junction which is dream, he is able to see both this world as well as the next, this birth as well as the next.
Idam cha paraloka sthanam cha,
this as well as the next birth.
How atha yatha akramoyam paraloka sthane bhavati tam akramam akramyam.
So whatever kind of an outfit rupadi is required for experiencing next birth, that kind of rupadi he acquires in the dream.
Ubhayan papana anandam sipasyati,
and he experiences both the pleasure and pain that would be coming in the next birth.
In the dream here, this is the idea here.
Look at the bhashya, just to go through it quickly.
Tasya etasya purushasya vai dveva sthane bhavatah na trutiyam chaturtham va.
Bhashyakara says, of this purusha or this atma, akim aham karushane
bhavatah, there are only two sthana of the two abodes, na trutiyam chaturtham va,
not more than two, there is not three nor four nor even less than two.
What are these two abodes for the Atma of the Self? Kete,
idam cha yat pratipannam vartamanam janma sharirendriya vishaya vedana vishishtam sthanam pratyakshatah anubhuyamanam. This body, in fact, this birth,
yat pratipannam vartamanam janma,
this present birth which has been acquired,
sharirendriya vishaya vedana vishishtam,
which is characterized by being body, sense organs, and the experience of sense objects, this birth characterized as this is the pratyakshata anubhuyamanam. So that which is a matter of our direct experience, this is the idam sthanam, this is this world.
Pratyakshata anubhuyamanam,
that this world, that is this birth, is a matter of our direct or immediate experience. We do not require any other evidence for establishing the existence of this birth.
Paralokasthanam, paralokahevasthanam, paralokasthanam.
The second one is paralokasthanam, the next birth. So what is paraloka? That is, of course, the contention here. That paraloka is, the question was asked here. But when you say, all this discussion arose, of course, from the previous kandika, when it was said, previous kandika means actually the seventh kandika. Right, 1001 in fact. See, 1001.
Katam atmeti yoyam vijnanameh praneshu hridyantarjyotih purushah.
The question was, katam atmeti, which one is atma?
Yoyam vijnanameh, the one identified with the vijnanam buddhi.
Praneshu, remaining within the prana, so the sense organs and the pranas were different from them.
Hridyantah.
So one that is within the hrudi, hrud meaning the buddhi, different from the buddhi also.
Purushaha,
so one who is consciousness.
Saha samanasan ubholoko anusancharati.
Assuming the likeness of the buddhi, he proceeds or moves between the two worlds. What are these two worlds? This is the question. Vashyakara said there, that these two worlds mean this birth and the next birth. So assuming the likeness of the upadhi, right now he is in this birth and then he goes to the next birth. Then of course came later dhyayativa, lelayativa. How do you say that he himself does not transmigrate from this birth to the other, but it is really the buddhi or the sukshma sharira that does? And it looks as though the atma transmigrates from this birth to the next on the identification of the buddhi. How do you say that all these conclusions about the Atma are not about the Atma but the Buddhi? Dhyayativa, lelayativa. Just as here also, he thinks as it were, he shakes as it were. And so, identifying with the karmendriya, he shakes, meaning he seems to act. Identifying with the buddhi or the mind, he thinks as it were. So, in fact, this thinking, his acting, etc. of the atma is not in a primary sense. It is only because of the identification of the upadhi. And therefore, in identification of the upadhi, the sukshma sharira, he travels from this birth to the next. Sahi svapno bhutva imam lokamatikramadi. That very same Atma who transmigrates from this birth to the next, svapna bhutva. Again, in identification of the buddhi in this life, svapna bhutva, becoming the dreamer. Imam lokamati kramati. He transcends this waking world, mrityoho rupani. He gives us the identification with he gives us the identification of the body and the sense organs which characterize the waking state and goes to the dream state. This was said. And then, on the page 1042, the next kandika.
Svayam purusho jayamanah shariram abhisampadyamanah papma bhi samsrijyate.
Svayam purusha. Again that atma jayamanah. When is born, that is what?
Shariram abhisampadyamanah.
That means when he takes up this body, when he takes up the new body or gets identified with the new body, papma vi samsrujyate. So when he is born, when he takes up the new body, what happens? Papma vi samsrujyate. He gets identified with the papa. He gets identified with the evil of the nature of this body, sense organs, etc. He gets identified with the new set of body, sense organs, which is called the birth of the atma.
Saha utkraman mriyamanah.
When he dies, then utkraman, he departs from this. Papmanah
vijahati.
That time he gives up the evils, meaning he gives up the identification with this karikana sanghata, that is called the death. And when he gets identified with the next karikana sanghata, that is called the birth. So birth and death have been described in this kandika. Dava Bhashyakara said, sa samanasan uholokam unsancharati. Assuming the likeness of the buddhi, he goes to, he travels between the two worlds. Bhashyakara interpreted those two worlds to mean the birth and death, that is this world and then this birth and the next. So, this was a contention. What is meant by the two worlds? Therefore, on the page 1045, this Purvapaksha, the question was raised.
Nanu nastaha asya ubhau lokau. Yau janma marana abhyam anukramena sancharati.
So Purvapakshi says that we say that these two worlds are not there.
Yau janma marana abhyam anukramena sancharati.
That you are saying that this atma anusancharati moves or travels janma marana abhyam by the process of birth and death. So by the process of death from this body and birth in the next body, that it travels between the two worlds, these two worlds are not there.
Svapna jagari deva.
We say that the two worlds are rather waking and dream or waking and sleep rather than this birth and the next birth.
Why? Svapna jagari deva pratyaksham avagamyate.
Look, the waking and the sleep or waking and the dream are those which are experienced by us directly. So we know that these two worlds are there, and therefore when the Upanishad refers to the two worlds, the Upanishad rather talks of the two states here rather than the two births. Whereas, well, this birth and the next, so next birth is not a matter of our direct experience. Whereas dream is a matter of our direct experience, and therefore the two worlds should rather mean the waking and the dream rather than this birth and the next birth.
Kenachit Pramanan, of course, Agama, the scriptures do tell us that there is next birth. But there is no direct or immediate experience of the next birth.
Therefore, we say that next birth is not, because there is no direct experience of it.
Tasmat eteva svapna jagarite ihaloka paraloka viti.
Therefore, when the Upanishad talks about ihaloka paraloka, this and the next world, it rather refers to the waking and the dream instead of this birth and the next as you interpret. This is how the Purvapaksha was. Uchchaden Bhashyakara says, this Kandika, the ninth Kandika, which is what we are discussing right now, is in fact an answer to this question, that even the next birth also is a matter of our direct experience. That we experience next birth also. It's a big contention. Where? In the dream. Tasya vaya tasya purushasya devasthane bhavatah idam cha paralokasthanam cha. This birth and next birth. Sandhyam trutiyam supnasthanam. The dream is a sandhi. It's a junction between this birth and next birth. How? Tasmin sandhi sthane tishthan ete uve sthane pashyati. Because remaining or experiencing the dream, he is able to see both this world as well as the next, this birth as well as the next. How? Atha yatha kramoyam paralokasthane bhavati tam akram akramme uhayan papana anandam sipasyati. Whatever kind of upadhi that is required to experience the next birth, that kind of an upadhi he actually takes up in the dream, in this birth, and with that upadhi he experiences the pleasure and pain that are to come in the next birth. This is how this Kandika is interpreted by Bhashyakara. And it is proper also, because then alone this ubhavloko anusancharati. And in case that was not clear, the previous Kandika said, jayamanah, mriyamanah, very clearly said. Unless of course you want to interpret jayamanah also as being in the waking state and mriyamanah as a dream state or something like that. But jayamanah sutkraman, so that means departing from this body. So those expressions were fairly clear with reference to describing this birth and the next. Therefore, Bhashyakara interprets the two worlds or abodes as meaning this birth and the next, and wants to show how the swapna is a sandhi, the junction between meeting place of this birth and the next. So that's why Bhashyakara said in the Bhashya that idam cha sthanam is vartamanam janma sharirendriya vishayavedana visishtam sthanam pratyakshata anubhuyamanam. This sthanam, this world is something that we experience. That is a matter of our own experience. Paraloka eva sthanam, paraloka sthanam. And the next birth, next abode is the paraloka sthanam is the next birth. Tachya shariradi yoga vyogottar kala anubhavyam. And the next birth is that which is to be experienced after the departing from this body. Nanu svapnobi paralokah tathata sati dve evaiti avadharanam ayuktam. So wait a minute. Even a dream also can be said with the other world with reference to the waking. So now we are talking about this birth, which is this abode, next birth, which is next abode, and we say that is even a dream, which is also an abode by itself. So in fact there are three abodes. Why does the Shruti say dve eva sthane bhavatah, that there are two abodes only? Dve eva, that means two are definitely there, or dve eva, two only are there. So how come? So two only. So if you say inclusion, then two are indeed there, then there could be third also. If it's a two only, then only two are there and not third. So we say the only two are there. He says the dve eva meaning what? Two are indeed there with the possibility of third. We say that only two, that means there is no possibility of the third. That's why Bhashyakara says, na trutiyam chaturtham va. So why does Shruti say only two? So answer, na. No, your contention is not right. Katham tahi. Sandhyam tata. So Shruti says, sandhyam trutiyam svapnasthanam. So Shruti also says trutiyam, you know. Having said sandhyam, then Shruti also says trutiyam. That is why the Purvapakshi says that is a trutiyam sthanam. He says, no, it is not trutiyam sthanam, it is sandhyam sthanam. Sandhyam is primary, trutiyam is secondary there. Iha loka paraloka yoho yas sandhihi tasmin bhavam sandhyam. So that which is sandhi, or the junction, or the meeting place of this birth and the next, so that is called sandhyam. That what obtains in that meeting place is called sandhyam. Yat tat yat trutiyam tat svapnasthanam. So what you think is a third is in fact nothing but the sandhi or the meeting point, meeting place between this birth and next. Tena sthana ditva avadharanam. Therefore, there are only two sthanas and not three. Nahi gramayoho sandhi tau eva gramopeksha trutiyatva pariganam arhati. So sandhi, the meeting place, cannot be counted as an independent place. Like when the two villages meet, that meeting point cannot be considered the third place. Similarly also, where the two births meet, that is a dream, it cannot be considered the third place or a third abode, it is only second.
Katham punaha tasya paralokasthanasya astitvam avagamyate. On the page 1048, says Bhashyakara, katham punaha tasya paralokasthanasya astitvam avagamyate yad apeksha svapnasthanam sandhyam bhave.
So how do we establish the existence of the next birth and call it the second abode, with reference to which you say that the svapna of the dream is the meeting place and not the independent abode?
Yatah tasmin sandhye svapnasthane tishthan bhavan vartamanah ede ubhesthane pashyati.
Because the Shruti herself says, because remaining in the dream, he perceives or he experiences both this world as well as the next. Therefore, we say that it is a meeting place and not an independent sthana.
Ubhe sthane pashyati kete ubhe.
What are these two? I mean, you could also have interpreted that svapna means the meeting point between the waking and sleep. And being in the dream, he experiences both. Partly he experiences waking, because it takes the matra of the waking, vasana of the waking, and therefore he experiences the waking world. And of course he experiences the sleep, because he is sleeping also. So that also would have been all right. But here Bhashyakara says, no, it is not those two. So svapna sandhi between waking and sleep seems to be okay. And that experiences both this world and next, that is partly waking because of the vasanas and the sleep, that also seems to be okay. But ubhav loko anusancharati, the transmigration doesn't happen there in earlier kandika, seventh kandika. So ubhav loko anusancharati, and then jayamanaha, mriyamanaha, all those words also were very clear to mean the birth and the death. That is why Bhashyakara says that the two worlds should mean this birth and the next birth.
Kete uve idam cha paraloka sthanam cha.
This world, this birth and the next.
Tasmatstah svapna jagrata vyatirekena ubhav loko.
Therefore we say that other than the waking and the sleep, that there are two abodes.
Yau dhya samarasan anusancharati janamana santana prabandhena.
That there are these two worlds, you know, this birth and next, which this self travels. Being identified with the buddhi, he moves or travels or transmigrates between these births. So this next birth is, or the two births are.
Katham punah svapne sthitah sanna ubhav loko pashyati.
How again, being in the dream state, that he experiences both these worlds, both these births.
Kim ashraya kena vidhanayati.
What ashraya? What kind of a support does he have? What kind of help does he have to experience the next birth?
Kena vidhana.
And in what manner does he experience the next birth?
Uchyate atha katham pashyati iti shrunu.
All right, atha, from the Shruti, listen as to how he sees them.
Yatha akramah, akramadhyanayanaiti akramah, ashraya avashtambah.
So that with which one akramadi proceeds or moves. So you require, in order to move, you require to have a support, you know. You require a vehicle, for example, to travel from one place to the other. Similarly, also to travel from this birth to the next, this atma requires a vehicle like ashraya
avashtambah.
In this case, it requires an upadhi. Atma doesn't require a vehicle, but atma requires a vehicle of the nature of upadhi to travel from this birth to the next. That is called yathakrama, yadrusha akrama yasya, soyam thakrama. Whatever akrama that upadhi is required, that upadhi acquires.
Ayam purusha paralokasthane pratipattavye nimitte vyathakramo bhavati.
That now he wants to experience the next birth.
Yathakramo bhavati.
Whatever upakrama or upadhi is required,
yadrushena paraloka pratipatti sadhanena vidyakarma pura prajna lakshanena yukto bhavati ityartha.
So in order to experience next birth, you require this vidya, karma, pura prajna. You require the upasana, rituals and the earlier vasanas, etc. That becomes samagri for transmigrating the next birth, acquiring the upadhi of the next birth and gaining experience of next birth. So similar thing he also acquires in the dream.
Tamakramam paralokasthanaya unmukhi bhutam.
Well, right now the preparations of next birth are going on right now. And therefore, we already have acquired the vasanas and we are performing the actions and we are entertaining various motivations and also we have inherited the past samskaras. All of these becomes the samagri or the material for the formation of next upadhi to gain the experience of pleasure and pain in the next birth, which is there in a potential form. So, these material which is there in a potential form, unmukhi bhudam, that becomes now ready to manifest.
Praptankuri bhavame bijam.
Just as a seed, now he is about to sprout. At that time, how does it become prepared to manifest the next stage, that is sprout? Similarly, also a part of our vidya, karma and pura prajna, all of that, they become ready to manifest themselves as the upadhi in the dream. For this jiva or atma to experience the experiences of the next birth.
Tam akram akramya avastabhya ashritya uvayan pasyati.
He sees both.
Uvayan,
ubho pasyati, but here plural.
Bahuvachanam dharma dharma phala anekatvad uvayan mani ubha prakaran ityartha uvaya prakaran.
So, both the kinds of experiences he gains.
Kamstan, paapmanaha, and then anandamscha.
This too doesn't mean this birth or the next birth. This ubhayan means the papa and the punya. So, thus in the dream, acquiring that upadhi which is required for gaining experiences of the next birth, he experiences the papa and the punya, that is papa phala and punya phala, that is the pleasure and pain which are to come in the next birth. He gets a glimpse of the pleasure and pain which are to come in the next birth. So this is what happens in the dream.
Papmana means papa phalani.
When we say experience of evil, which means the results of the evil, which is the pain.
Nadu punha sakshadeva papmanam darshanam sambhavati. Tasmat papa phalani dukkhani ityartha.
Nobody experiences papa directly. What you experience is the result of the papa. So when Upanishad says he experiences papa or the evil, that means he experiences dukkha. He experiences pain, which is a result of the evil.
Anandamsya dharma phalani sukhani ityartha.
And he also experiences dharma phalani, the results of the dharma or the punya, which is sukha or the pleasure.
Tan uvayan papmanah anandam se pasyati.
He experiences both the papa and the punya, that is the pain as well as the pleasure. Now, the footnote said that there are three avasthas.
Malya yavana vardhakya bhedena.
That the human being has the three avasthas, the childhood, early childhood, the middle age, and then the old age. Early childhood means he has just come from the previous birth. Old, very old age means he is ready now to go to the next birth. So that way, it is said here,
janmantra drushta vasanamayan.
Janmantra drushta. What he has experienced the previous birth, he has carried the vasanas with him. And an infant also experiences dream. Now, if we say that dream is a product of the vasanas or the impressions of the experiences gathered in this life, the infant has not yet begun the life. And therefore, he could not possibly be dreaming because he doesn't have the material, namely the vasana, the samskara, the impressions required to form the dream. And still we find the infants also sometimes crying and weeping or laughing, etc. in the dream. That means that they also are dreaming. That means that they must be dreaming the things of the past birth, of the vasana, the impressions brought from the past birth. Therefore, the dream experience of the infant, in a way, can be looked upon as the evidence of the existence of the past birth, because he dreams the experience of the past birth. In the middle age, generally, the person experiences only the dreams which are based on the impressions of this life, because he is fully now formed to gain experience of this world. When he is approaching death, yeyasuhu paralokam yeyasuhu, when he is now approaching the next birth, that is approaching the death, at that time, yani ca pratipattavya janma vishayani kshudra dharma dharma phalani tani pashyati. It is a very old age, and approaching death, at that time, he dreams, and the dreams are, dream in the dream, he does gain the glimpse or experiences of the pleasure and pain in the next birth. How? Dharma dharma prayukta. Because of the four Sikshudra dharma dharma phalani. So the footnote said that there are certain kind of dharma karma which give rise to part result here and the rest result in the next birth. So such karmas, they may give rise to the part result here which he experiences in the dream and the rest he experiences in the next birth. What makes him do that? Dharma dharma prayukta. As prompted by the Pava Punyadi is done. Devata, there is some very strong Pava Punya may be there which may be ready to give rise to result here itself, partly, you know, and then the rest they appear in the next birth, something like that. Devata Anugrahadva, or by the Anugraha, the grace of God, that he experiences or gains the glimpses of the next birth in the dream. On the page 1050, Tat Katham Avagamyate. Paralogasthana sambandhi papmananda darshanam sapnayati. Hey, when he experiences pleasure and pain in the dream, how do you say that those pleasure and pains belong to the next birth? How do you conclude that? Uchyate shrutya, that is being said. Or by Bhashyakara, I think, Bhashyakrita uchyate. Yasmat iha janmani anubhavyamapi bahupashyati. So now, Bhashyakara says, because in this birth also, person does gain experience in the dream of the thing which has not been experienced. Ananubhavyamanamapi, ananubhutamapi. So one does see things which have never been seen. Then maybe in the dream he does see things which has never been seen. Maybe in the dream one does gain unique experiences. Why do you insist that in the dream one has to see the result, product of the impressions of what has been seen? That is the idea. In the dream, nothing new can ever be experienced, or whatever is experienced in the dream must be a result of the impressions of the experiences already gained. Now, if in the dream one does experience things which have not been experienced in this life, then we have to conclude that those experiences must be based on the impressions which are carried from the past life. Therefore, those experiences in the dream, which cannot be explained by the experience of the waking, have to be considered as experiences coming from the past life or experiences revealing the glimpses of the future life, depending upon what karma is predominant. Yasmat iha janmani ananubhavyamapi bahupashyati. Therefore, in the dream it is found that people do experience things which have not been experienced in this life. Then somebody may say that, then in the dream one gains altogether new experiences. Why not? Says, na cha svapnaha nama apurvam darshanam. Says, no, in a dream one cannot gain altogether a new experience.
Then, purva drishta smritirhi svapna prayana.
Generally speaking, svapna is nothing but the product of smriti, the memories of what has been experienced in the past. Memories is from the memories is the nature of samskara. And the samskara are projected as a dream world. In that sense, they say to be memory.
Tena svapna jagat.
Therefore, when you see things that cannot be explained by the experiences of this life, then we have to say that those experiences come because of the impressions of the other life. Then those experiences become the evidence of the existence of another birth over and above this birth. It could very well be the past birth, but there can be cases when it could even be the glimpses of the next birth. If those karmas are very predominant, another person is now about to die or going to die, therefore the next janma becomes sort of, looms large now in his personality as to what is going to happen. Therefore it is possible that one may gain the glimpses of the experience of the next birth in the dream while one is approaching death.
Tena svapna jagare sthana vyatirekena staha ubhau lokau.
Therefore, there are these two worlds. No doubt, of course, the scriptures do say that there is new birth, etc. It's very clear. But apparently here Shruti wants to point out an experience or evidence, wants to give an evidence of the next birth or the previous birth over and above the scripture, that wants to give the evidence in the form of our own experience. And dream is a state where these experiences happen. Therefore, Bhashyakara says that the sandhyam sthanam trutiyam svapna sthanam. The sandhyam trutiyam svapna sthanam. That svapna becomes the sandhi, becomes the meeting point, a junction between this world and the next. So this discussion is over. Now the Shruti has to continue with the next discussion. Now go to the page 1047. Sattam akramya uhyan papmanah anandam sipashyati. This part has been discussed. Up to this, the discussion has already been done. Now, then Shruti is sahayatra prasvapiti. Now when he sleeps, in this case when he dreams, because swap is in the sense of sleeping as well as dreaming. Asya lokasya. Now Bhashyakara says that this is the description of the dream state. And that twist, why the dream state? Why the explanation of dream state or description of dream state? To establish swayam jyotishtvam, the self-effulgence of the Atma. So, Saitra Prasvapidi, Asya Lokasya Sarvavada Matram Apadaya. We discussed it earlier, that at that time he takes the part of this all-embracing world, that is the waking world. Matram here means the samskara, the impressions of the experiences gained in this waking state. Swayam Vihatya, he himself makes this waking body unconscious. Swayam Nirmaya, he himself creates a new body for the dream. Svena Bhasa, and by his own luster the dream world is created. Svena Jyotisha Prasvapiti, and by his own effulgence he experiences the dream world. So by his own luster he creates the dream world, and by his own light he illumines that world. Atrayam Purusha Svayam Jyotir Bhavati. In the dream this Purusha the Atma becomes Svayam Jyotihi. That means that he himself becomes alive, or he is a self-effulgence. So self-effulgence of the Atma can be very clearly established with reference to the dream state. That is why the description of the dream experience. Atma is Svayam Jyoti regardless. But the Svayam Jyotishtvam, the self-effulgence of the Atma, can be very clearly established without any doubt with reference to the dream state. That is why the description of the dream experience here. This is how Bhashyakara now introduces this passage. And in
So, and then explains it. On the, now going back to page 1050, in the second paragraph, Anandagiri says, Sayatra ityadi vakya, sayatra is said, sayatra prasvapiti, we just read that vakya, ityadi vakyasya, vyavahitena sambandham vaktum, vyavahitena, footnote 11, so there is a mistake there, it's not Brahma Sutra really. That it is, that Brahma Sutra part should come with the previous footnote. In the previous line it says 3, 2, 4, 8. That is what Brahma Sutra is. Suchakaschahi Shrutehe Achakshadeh Tadvidaha. We discussed it last time. So that is Brahma Sutra 3, 2, 4. So that Brahma Sutra appearing in the footnote 11 should be connected, we should go to the previous one. And in the footnote 11 you find 4, 3, 5, which should rather be 4, 3, 5. Let me see, page 986 I think. It should be rather 436, not 435. See, Bhashyakara refers to this, wants to connect now this Svayam Jyotishtvam. On the page 986, King Janaka asks this question, Astamite Aditya Yagnivalkya Chandramasi Astamite Shante Agnau Shantayam Vachi Kim Jyotirevayam Purushahiti. In the ongoing dialogue between King Janaka and Sri Yajnavalkya, then King Janaka asks here, Astamite Aditye, when the sun has set, hey Yajnavalkya, Chandramasi Astamite, when the moon also has set, Shante Agnav, when the fire is put off, Shantayam Vachi, and when the speech and such other sense organs also have become quiet. Referring to the dream state, this is what happens. In the dream state, one gives up the identification with the gross body as well as all the sense organs. Kim jyotirevayam purushahedi. At that time, what is the jyoti of the light with which this purusha, this jivatma characterized by karyakarana sanghata, he performs his vyavahara in absence of all these conventional lights also, then what is the light? Atma evasya jyotirbhavati. Say Yajnavalkya, hey King, hey Janak, hey Samrat, Atma, the self becomes the very light, so which illumines the vyavahara of this Jivatma. Atmana evayam jyotisha aste palyayate karma kurate vipalyayate. Hey Janaka, it is by the light of the self, that in the dream, that this person aste, he sits, karma palyayate, he goes out, karma kurute, does various chores, vipalyayati, and returns. In short, all the vyavahara is performed by the light of the self. In fact, that happens in every state. In the waking also, it is only by the light of the self that vyavahara takes place, but that is not clear because so many other lights are there. Therefore, one may have a question as to whether it is the sun and the moon and the fire and the speech that is in the vyavahara, so it looks like. Since it cannot be very clearly established, at least for an uninitiated in the waking state, therefore the Shruti takes us to the dream state to make it very clear that is Atma, which is self-effulgent and a light of which is responsible for all the vyavahara. So Vashyakara connects now this discussion with the second part of the ninth Kandika that we are discussing. That's what Anandagiri said. Sayatra ityadi vakyasya vyavahitena sambandham vaktum. Vyavahita meaning that which is separated. What is separated? Not just the immediately previous kandika, but the sixth kandika. This is the ninth kandika. So that there is a gap between the two. So something comes in between them. Vyavahitena sambandham vaktum, sambandham vaktum. To establish sambandha, the sangati, the connection with that particular passage. Vruttam anudya akshapati. Vruttam anudya. Reiterating or restating what has already gone by. Akshapati questions. questions the very existence of the Atma Jyoti or the Swayam Jyoti, that is Atma. Yadityadina. So, this part of the passage is in the form of a question. Akshepa Sangati. You question that very thing, so you make a statement. Somebody questions the statement. That is, questions the validity of the statement. And then you reply. So then your reply is in response to the questioning, in response to the negation. When somebody questions, he meaningly negates what you are saying. And then you positively establish that. So Shruti said, Atma eva asya jyotir bhavati. The self alone becomes a jyoti. Atmana evam jyoti. Well, it is the self that does all the vyavahara that is being questioned. How can it be? It cannot be. And then Bhashyakara says, Yatrayam swapidi, so praswapidi. That is the reply to that negation. So, yet, then says Bhashyakara, Yat adityadi bahya jyotisham abhave ayam karyakarana sanghatah purushah yena vitriktena atmana jyotisha vyavaharati ityuktam tadeva nasti yaduktam. This has been said. What has been said? Adityadi bahya jyotisham abhave astamite aditya yajnavalkya astamite chandramasi shante agnau shantayam vachi. That means what? Adityadi bahya jyotisham abhave. So King Janaka is specifically asking about a state when all these conventional illuminators are not there. Ayam kim jyotirevayam purushah. Then what is the jyoti by which this purusha, the jivatma, performs all the vyavahara? Atma evasya jyotir bhavati. This was the reply. That means that there is a state when all these conventional jyotis, that is Aditya, Chandramas, Agni, Vag, etc. are not there. In that state, Atma is the jyoti. So then the Purupakshi here, somebody questions, says, where is such a state? That when all these conventional jyotis or lights are not there, there is no such state at all. Yet adityadi bahya jyotisham bhave. So this is called vrittam anuvad, vritta anuvada. This reiterating what has been said in the previous kandika, the sixth kandika. Yet adityadi bahya jyotisham bhave. Ayam karyakana sanghatah purushah. That in the absence of all these lights, such as sun, etc., I am Purushaha. There is Karyakana Sanghata Purushaha. There is Purusha of the Atma, the Self. Here Karyakana Sanghata, this Sanghata, the Upadhi, characterized by the gross and the subtle bodies. Yena Vitiriktena Atmana Jyotisha Vyavahrati. That there is an Atma Jyoti, that is the light or the effulgence of the nature of Atma by which this Karyakana Sanghata performs of Vyavahara. Iti Yaduktam. This is what you said. Where? Brihadaranyaka Upanishad 4.36 that we already read. Tadeva Nasti, footnote number 2 says, Tatra Iti Adihi. That means in the beginning, Tatra should be there. Tatra Tadeva Nasti. Tatra, with reference to that, we have to say that tadeva nasti, that Atma Jyotihi is not there. Says Anandagiri, Bahya Jyotira Bhave Sati Ayam Purushaha Karyakana Sanghataha Yena Sanghata Adriktena Atma Jyotisha Gamana Gamana Adi Nirvartayati Tadatma Jyoti Hasti Iti Yaduktam Iti Anuvadartha Iti Uktam Yaduktam. That Yad in the beginning comes to Uktam. Bahya Jyoti Rabhaya Sati, when there is an absence of all these external lights. Ayam Purusha means Karyakana Sanghataha. This complex nature of the body and the gross and the subtle bodies. Yena Jyotisha Yena Sanghata Atriktena Atma Jyotisha. By the jyoti, which is different from this Karyakana Sanghata. So, gamana gamana adi nirvartayati, accomplishes all this gamana gamanam.
आस्ते पल्येते कर्म कुरुते विपल्येति ऑल ऑफ दिस तो आत्म ज्योति अस्ति इति यदुक्तम यू सेड दैट देयर इज एन आत्म ज्योति बाय विच ऑल द व्यवहार टेक्स प्लेस इन एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑल दिस कन्वेंशनल इल्यूमिनेटर्स इति अनुवादार्थ दैट पार्ट इज अनुवाद रिटरेशन ऑफ व्हाट इज गॉन बाय देन सेज आनगिरि विशिष्ट स्थान अभाव वक्तुम विशेषण अभाव तावत् दर्शयति विशिष्ट स्थान अभाव वक्तुम सच ए स्थानम सो वेयर देयर इज एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑल दिस लाइट सच ए स्पेसिफिक प्लेस इज नॉट देयर विशिष्ट स्थान अभाव फुटनोट नंबर 9 बाह्य ज्योतिरभाव विशिष्ट स्वप्न स्थानम इति भावः बाह्य ज्योतिरभाव विशिष्ट So, Swapnasthanam, the dream state characterized by the absence of the external light. That is called Vishishtasthanam. So, Vishishtasthanam means Swapnasthana Abhavam Vaktum, Visheshana Abhavam. Vishishta cannot be there if Visheshana is not there. So, Vishishta means that which is qualified. The qualified thing cannot be there if the qualification is not there, you know. So, when you want to say that there is a red flower, you know. So, red flower cannot be there if red color is not there. So, red becomes the visheshana. The visheshtam is that which is characterized by. So, that characterized or qualified thing cannot be there if the qualification is not there. Engineer is a qualified person. Engineering is the qualification. If such a thing, where is the engineering kind of a thing is not there, there cannot be an engineer. So, if you want to prove the absence of something, you can prove the absence of the characteristic. In this case, you want to prove the absence of dream state. This person who is asking, what is dream state? That which is characterized by the absence of the lights. He says such a thing as absence of the lights, such a state is not there. It is never that the lights are absent, they are always there. And therefore, there cannot be a state such as dream state that you are claiming to be there, which is characterized by the absence of the external lights. विशेषण अभाव फुटनोट 10 बाह्य ज्योतिरभावात्मक विशेषण एब्सेंस ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल लाइट्स सो सच स्टेट इज नॉट देयर दिस कंडीशन इज नॉट देयर एंड देयर वाज ड्रीम स्टेट कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय दिस कंडीशन आल्सो इज नॉट देयर सो विशेषण अभाव दर्शयति विशिष्ट स्थान अभाव वक्तुम विशेषण अभाव दर्शयति तदेव इति तदेव नास्ति दैट इज दिस काइंड ऑफ एन एब्सेंस ऑफ द लाइट्स इज नॉट देयर श्री दानगिरी आदित्यादि ज्योतिरभाव विशिष्ट स्थानम दैट स्थानम दैट स्टेट कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द एब्सेंस ऑफ द लाइट सच एज आदित्य यत्र इति उक्तम यत्र अयम प्रस्वपिति यत्र सो व्हिच वी आर सेइंग देयर वेयर दिस वन ड्रीम्स तदेव स्थानम नास्ति सच अ स्टेट इज नॉट देयर नास्ति फुटनोट 11 नास्ति इति अन्तस्य अत्रापि अनुषंग शेषांतर्गतम वायदम और यू कैन से दैट नास्ति इति अन्तस्य अन्तस्य अप टू दैट पॉइंट अत्रापि अनुषंग शेषांतर्गतमेव वायदम सो अप टू दैट पॉइंट यू कैन से इज अनुषंग मीन दैट संगति इज देयर अप टू दिस पॉइंट तदेव स्थानम नास्ति विशेषण अभावादि शेष है सो वी से दैट द स्थानम इज नॉट देयर बिकॉज ए स्टेट कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस लाइट्स इज नॉट देयर एंड देयरफॉर दैट स्थानम आल्सो कैन नॉट बी देयर यथोक्त स्थान अभाव हेतुमाह विशेषण अभावात्मकम एव उक्तम हेतु उपादयति हेतु मीन्स द एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस एब्सेंस ऑफ विशेषण मीनिंग एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस lights. So, he explains how such a thing is not there. Yena iti. Yena sarvada eva ayam karyakana sanghataha samsrushta eva upalabhyade ayam yena because sarvada eva अयम कार्यगण संघात वी फाइंड दैट दिस कार्यगण संघात उपाधि सर्वदा एव संसृष्ट उपलभ्यते is always found to be associated with these lights.
Siddhanagi samsrishtah bahyaihi jyotibhiti sheshah.
That this Sanghata is always found to be associated with Aditya, some one or the other lights anyway, and therefore that it is absent, or that there is a state when the Sanghata does not have the benefit of one of these lights, such a state is not there.
Siddhanagi vyavahara bhumo bahya jyotir abhava abhave phalitamah vyavahara bhumo.
In this vyavahara means in our day-to-day transactions,
bahya jyoti rabhava bhave,
absence of the bahya jyoti. That means these jyotis are always present.
Deva phalitamaha.
So what it amounts to? Tasmadidi.
So Vashya says, tasmad asat samaha asannevava svena vivikta svabhavena jyoti rupena atma iti. Tasmat avataranoktartham,
that means the Tika has already explained that.
Tasmat, therefore,
since there is no absence of the absence, there is no such state of absence of all these lights, therefore,
asat samaha,
your Atma Jyoti is as good as non-existent, asat samaha.
Asanneva, or we say that it is not there at all.
Va svena vivikta svabhavena. In short, that Atma Jyoti can never be obtained as separate from the rest of the Jyoti. Even if such a thing as Atma Jyoti is there, number one, you cannot establish that Atma Jyoti can be experienced or can obtain in absence of or separate from the rest of the Jyotis. Therefore, how can you establish that there is an Atma Jyoti which is responsible for the Vyavahara when the Atma Jyoti never obtains independent of the external Jyotis? Therefore,
asat samaha
asanneva, as good as not there, at least
vivikta svabhavena jyoti rupena atma.
That atma ever obtains an instead as its own light, in absence and devoid of rest of lights, and it illumines the vyavahara, such a thing is not there, as good as not there, or not there at all. This is just a question.
Just to establish Sangati with the sixth Khandika, basically. The Purva Paksha, etc. The question that can arise in somebody's mind. Then Anandagiri says, Uttara Grantham Uttaratvena Avatarayati Yatra Swapit Prasvapiti.
That Grantha, that section, is explained by Bhashyakara as a reply to this particular question, where somebody feels that where is the state where Atma Jyoti independently obtains, such a state is not there, then these subsequent passages in reply to this question.
Uttaratvena yathokta akshepa samadhanatvena,
as samadhanam, as resolving this particular akshepa or the questioning.
Atha ityadina. Oh, that can also be a part of the question itself. Atha kvachita viviktah svena jyoti rupena upalabhyeta bahya adhyatmika bhuta bhautika samsarga shunyah tatah yathoktam sarvam bhavishyati ityetadarthamaha.
Atha, if however, kvachita, somewhere, foot number 4, kutrachisthvane, kva means where, kvachita, someplace, that is kutrachisthvane, if there were a state where
viviktah svena jyoti rupena upalabhyeta.
If, however, there was a state where Atma obtained merely as his own effulgence, devoid of an so without the support of the external jyoti, such a state had it been there,
bahya adhyatmika bhuta bhautika samsarga shunya.
So here even the karyakarana sanghata also, if this karyakarana sanghata also obtained without the contact with external jyotis,
bahya आध्यात्मिक भूत भौतिक है. सो फुट नंबर 5 विविक्त यदि उत्तम विवरण होती बाह्य बाह्य आध्यात्मिक भूत भौतिक विशेषण है. सो भूत भौतिक, भूत मीन्स एलिमेंट्स एंड भौतिक मीन्स एलिमेंटल्स. बाह्य मीन्स एक्सटर्नल, आध्यात्मिक मीन्स पर्टेनिंग टू वन्स ओन सेल्फ. द आइडिया इज दैट द एक्सटर्नल लाइट्स आर देयर सच एज सन एंड मून, द इंडिविजुअल लाइट्स आर देयर सच एज आईज एंड इयर्स एटसेट्रा, दीज आर ऑल्सो द ज्योतिष. सो बाह्य एंड आध्यात्मिक, all of these are the products of bhuta and bhautika, the external as well as the lights obtaining, the sense organs obtaining the individual level, they are products of the 5 elements or the elementals. So bhuta bhautika samsarga shunya, if you can establish that atma can be shunya, devoid of samsarga or association with this external as well as individual lights, upalabhyeta, if atma did obtain in a condition like that, ततः देन यथोक्तम सर्वं भविष्यति, देन व्हाटएवर यू सेड इज ओके, दैट आत्मा इज स्वयं ज्योति, दैट वुड बी ऑल राइट इफ ए स्टेट लाइक दैट वर देयर इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस. सी फुटनोट, ततः बाह्यादि असंसृष्टत्वात्, सिंस देन इज अनएसोसिएटेड विद एनी एक्सटर्नल लाइट्स, देन वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दैट व्हाटएवर व्यवहार टेक्स प्लेस इन दैट स्टेट इज ड्यू टू द लाइट ऑफ द आत्मा. इति this is how it would have been. Since the question can be there, and since that question can be resolved, if it can be established that there is a state wherein Atma is devoid of the contact of the external lights, then of course, whatever Upanishad has said, Atma eva asya jyotir bhavati, Atmana eva ayam jyoti shastra, etc., what Shruti herself has said, that itself would have been all right if Shruti herself can establish that there is a state which is devoid, where the Atma is, doesn't have the support of any of the light, external or conventional lights, then what the Upanishad said would have been all right. Until then, what the Upanishad said is not all right. Therefore, in order to support the statement that the Shruti herself made, this passage is given by the Shruti in support of what has been said earlier. This is how Bhashyakara connects the 6th and the 9th Khandikas. श्रीदानक यथोक्तम सर्व व्यतिरिक्तत्वम स्वयं ज्योतिष्टम इत्यादि, दैट आत्मा इज सर्व व्यतिरिक्त है, इज सेपरेट और असंग है, अनकनेक्टेड टू एवरीथिंग, स्वयं ज्योतिष्टम दैट इज सेल्फ इफल्जेंट, ऑल ऑफ दिस दैट यू हैव स्टेटेड, ऑल ऑफ दैट विल बी ऑल राइट. आह स्वप्नम प्रस्तौति इति यावद, दैट मीन्स दैट इन ऑर्डर टू क्लैरिफाई दिस द उपनिषद नाउ इंट्रोड्यूसेस टॉक्स अबाउट स्वप्न और द ड्रीम, which is a state where all these conventional lights are not there, and still vyavahara similar to the waking takes place, and therefore it gets established that all that vyavahara takes place only by the light, that is the Atma. Okay, now reading the Bhashya on the page 1051. Before that, we have to, let us read also this Krodapatra, which is on the bottom of page 1050. See, Anandika says, Yatra, sa yatra ityade vakshasa vyavahite na sammanham vaktum. So, vyavahite, there is a asterisk there. And you see that Krodapatra at the bottom of that page 1050, vyavahite na sammanham vaktum ityade. Atra ahuhu vartika kara padaha. So the revered Vartikaras have this to say with reference to Vyavahitena Sambandha. Tathahi, to illustrate here. Yaduktam viraheshesha suryadi jyotishamayam puman vyavahatyatma jyotishayivedi lingataha bhanvadi sarva jyotibhya viktoyam pumanadi kva siddhaydi vaktavyam yathoktartha prasiddhaye swayam jyotif prasiddhirva पूर्व मुक्तानुमानतः साक्षात् व्यवधानेन तत्प्रसिद्धिरथोच्यते स स्वयं ज्योतिरात्मैव बाह्य ज्योतिर्विवर्जितः यथा भवति साक्षात् च तथेदमभिधीयते. दिस मेनी वार्तिका आर देयर इति, एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स दैट इज ऑन द पेज 1051 द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दीज वार्तिका आर देयर बॉटम. स यत्र इत्यादि अवतारयितुं व्यवहितम वृत्तम कीर्तयति सयत्र इत्यादि अवयत्र प्रस्वपिति इत्यादि अवतारयितुम इन ऑर्डर टू इंट्रोड्यूस एक्सप्लेन व्यवहितम वृत्तम कीर्तयति व्यवहितम वृत्तम व्हाट हैज गॉन बाय अर्लियर बिकॉज जस्ट इमीडिएटली बिफोर दिस बर्थ एंड डेथ एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट वी डिस्कस यू नो एंड सो व्हाई दे वी डिस्कस व्हाटएवर द रीजन यू नो एंड द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिवन दैट्स नॉट द मेन टॉपिक एनीवे This birth and death and transmigration is not the topic of this. And still Shruti mentioned, so Bhashyakara says anyway. And anyway, so Bhashyakara says. So it is in fact out of context, I mean as far as we can see, because the whole prakrana is Jyotir Brahman. To establish this self-effulgence of the Atma. But anyway, in between Shruti did mention this birth and next and gave explanation also. So there was a bit of a digression in between, in those two kandikas. The seventh and eighth kandikas, there was a bit of a digression. That is why Bhashyakara has to connect the second passage. So first part of the ninth kandika gets connected to the seventh and eighth kandikas, and second part of the ninth kandika gets connected to the sixth kandika. That is why this vyavahita sambandha had to be established. Vyavahitam vrittam kirta yaduktamiti. So the first vartika said, yaduktam virahe ashesha. Suryadi Jyotisham Yaduktam, that which has been said, explaining what we just read in the Bhashya. Ashesha Suryadi Jyotisham Virahe. All these Jyotis, beginning from Surya all the way up to this Vak, so Virahe, without them, in absence of them, Ayam Puman Vyavaharati. That this Puman, meaning this Karyakana Sanghata, performs the Vyavahara. Atma Jyotisha Evaiti. That he performs the vyavahara by the light of the self, iti lingataha, by the linga, by the evidence it is saying. That Atma is a self-effulgent because of the vyavahara. So, here the Shruti, in this particular section, as we said earlier, that what the Shruti says is to provide the reasoning to establish the self-effulgence of the Atma. That Atma transcends all the three states. That is asangoyam purusha, that is asanga. So, neti neti, by negating all the visheshas of the Atma, this Shruti wants to establish that. So, this is how the purpose of this section is. But then, what has already been stated briefly, is now sought to be established with reason. Therefore, this Brahul Brahmana is meant to establish how Atma is asangha nirvisheshaha by reasoning. In that process also the Swayam Jyotishtvam or the self-effulgence of the Atma is also being established. So here the discussion is lingataha. The Shruti provides linga, the evidence, to sort of prove the statements that we made earlier. So what is linga? To establish the Swayam Jyotishtva or the self-effulgence of the Atma, what is the linga? If the vyavahara, vyavahara itself becomes linga. What kind of vyavahara? Vyavahara in absence of all conventional source of light. So, without, in absence of all the lights, also if vyavahara can take place, that light must come from somewhere. It must only come from Atma. Therefore, Atmanayavayam Jyotishaste. Therefore, Atma, that is how gets established or proven as self-effulgent. So, linga. So, vyavahara. In the dream state, which is characterized by absence of all the lights, becomes a linga to establish the self-effulgence of the Atma. See the tika, lingatahaivi. Adityadi jyotirabhavevi drishta svapnadi gadavasanadi vyavaharvashadityartha. Adityadi jyotirabhavevi, in absence of this jyoti such as aditya, drishta svapnadigata vasanadi vyavahara vashad, svapnadigata vasanadi vyavahara. We find in the svapna also the vyavahara takes place even when all these jyotis are not there. Drishta, this is what we know, and so that becomes a linga to establish the swayam jyotishtam of the Atma. Tatra chodya mullasati iti sheshah. So yad uktam lingatah uktam. यद लिंगतः उक्तम आदित्य अशेष सूर्यादि ज्योतिषां विरहे अयम पुमान आत्मज्योतिषा एव व्यवहरति इति यद लिंगतः उक्तम तत्र चोद्यमुल्लसति विथ रेफरेंस टू दैट दिस क्वेश्चन अराइजेस So that is how the connection is.
Anantara vakyartham akanksha purvakam sankshipyah. Anantara,
the vakya that follows subsequently, the artha, the meaning of that vakya, the svapna, is sankshipya, in brief, so akanksha purvakam.
So Vartikara here gives the briefly the meaning of the svapna vakya with akanksha, with the question, bhanuvaditi.
So the second Vartika says, bhanuvadi sarvajyotir bhya viviktoyam pumadi kva siddhaiti vaktavyam.
Bhanuvadi sarvajyotirbhya vivikta ayam puman. Ayam puman, ayam karyakarana sanghata, this karyakarana sanghata,
bhanuvadi sarvajyotirbhya vivikta.
He is totally devoid of all the jyotis, beginning from Bhanu, the sun, etc. Kva siddha? Where does it happen that the karyakarana sanghata or the vyavahara rather, it takes place in absence of these lights? Where does it take place?
Iti vaktavyam. That is what the Upanishad also has to say.
Yathoktartha prasiddhe. To establish what you say, that is Atma, by whose light the vyavahara takes place, you must establish, Shruti herself must establish a state where Atma is allo jyoti, Atma alone is a jyoti, and other jyotis are not there. Iti.
So that is how akanksha purukam sankshipyaha.
So this is what the Shruti says, that there is a state, namely dream, where there is an absence of all these lights, where the vyavahara takes place. So sankshipyaha.
Says the Tika, Adityadi Jyotira Sprashtaha Chidatma Kutra Siddhaiti Prashte Jignyasitam Sthanam Yismad Vachyam Tasmad Bahya Jyoti Rahitasya Sthanasya Yathoktarthasya Pradashanartham Sayatra Ityadi Vakyamidi Yojana.
Adityadi Jyotira Sprashtaha Chidatma. Chidatma, the consciousness, that is the self, which is then devoid of all the other jyoti, such as Aditya. Kutra siddha, where does it happen that Atma is devoid of all the other jyotis? Iti prashte, when a question like this is asked,
jignyasitam sthanam ismad vachyam.
So the Shruti has to say that sthanam which is thought to be known here,
tasmad bahya jyoti rahitasya sthanasya yathoktarthasya pradashanartham.
Therefore, then there is a sthanam that is devoid of all the external lights, so pradashanartham, to demonstrate that sthanam, sayatra ityadi vakyam, so that is the vakyam beginning from sayatra, so that is meant to establish or demonstrate that there is a sthanam devoid of the external jyotis where the vyavahara takes place nevertheless. So that is sambandha. There is sambandha of that passage, sayatra prasvapiti, with the sixth kandika. Then together sambandhantrama. So it's one way of looking at the connection that this part of the passage has with the previous kandika, or sambandhantaram. Or you can see another connection also, which Vartikara gives. First of all, Vartikara gives the same sambandha which Bhashyakara has given, and then he also gives sambandha of different, slightly different kind.
Swayamiti. So the Vartika says, Swayam jyotih prasiddhirva puru mukta anumanatah sakshadavyavadhanena tat prasiddhirthochate.
Or you can put it this way, that purvam svayam jyotih prasiddhihi, that's the one word actually, svayam jyotih prasiddhirva anumanatah puru mukta. So purvam, earlier, anumanatah. So what the Shruti said earlier was anumana, by inference, that atma is svayam jyotih prasiddhihi. That atma is svayam jyotihi, that was said by anumana earlier.
Sakshat avyavadhanena tat prasiddhi atha uchyate.
Then you can say that now, in this part of the passage, Shruti says, how you directly, sakshat avyavadhanena. Earlier only by anumana it was said, now here it is said by our direct experience. How in the dream, we directly experience this swayam jyotish from the atma, and therefore, tat prasiddhi atha uchyate. That swayam atma is swayam jyoti, that is being now established with the direct experience. That is another way of looking at this connection, the role of this passage.
That's what Tika said. Atmaivasetyadu vyavaharlingam anumanatah svaprakasha chidatma ukta.
Same passage that we read.
Atmaivasya jyotirbhavati ityadu. Vyavahara linga anumanatah.
So the vyavahara becomes a linga. That
aste karma kurute, then what is palyayate, vipalyayate iti.
So that vyavahara takes place in dream. Therefore we say that the atma is swayam jyoti.
So vyavahara linga anumanatah.
So that vyavahara in the dream becomes a linga, the evidence for establishing swayam jyoti to the atma. And so there it is by the anuman that was said.
Anumanatah svaprakasha chidatma uktah.
Then the sixth kandika, by anuman inferendi atma is svaprakasha, that was said.
At aparoksh anubhavad.
Now by aparoksh anubhavad.
Pratyek bhavena tat siddhirvachya.
That is nothing but my own self. Aparoksh anubhavad is an immediate experience. So by the immediate experience, that jyoti must be known as my own self. Tat siddhivachya. That also must be. That Atma Jyoti is there, and that is my own self, and that must be established by direct experience, that also should be done. Iti Uttaram Vakyam. For that purpose, is Uttar Vakya, this passage is there. That is another way, another sambandha that Vartikara gives. Tika says,
Uktam sambandha dvayam eki tratya sukha pratipatyartham sangrannadi.
Uktam sammandadvayam, both the sammandha. Either you must establish a sthanam where this is there, or that this passage tells you by a direct experience that the Atma is Swayam Jyoti.
Uktam sammandadvayam ekikrutya, combining both the sammandhas, sukha pratipatyartham,
so that we can easily understand or grasp, sangrannadi saha.
So, both of these are now combined in the next verse. Sasvayam jyotiratmaiva bahya jyotirvivarjitah yatha bhoti sakshacha tathedam abhidhiyate.
That's all.
Sasvayam jyotihi atmaiva bahya jyotirvivarjitah.
Both are there. How bahya jyotirvivarjitah? How the atma is devoid of the support of all the external lights? Svayam jyotis is self-evulgent. Yatha bhoti sakshacha. And how that can become our immediate experience of the very self? Tatha idam avidyate, both of these are stated in the next passage. So both the sambandhas are combined. And so that we can understand them, Vartikara combined them. The Tika says,
Sahedi, sakhalu atma bahyehi jyotibhi asprashtah, svayame vetha jyotir bhavadi tatha idam svayam jyotishtum sakshat anubhoyogyam sapna dushtantena uchale. Sakhalu atma, that chidatma, bhakyehi jyotibhi asprashtaha, unconnected with the external lights, svayameva yatha jyotir bhavati, how he will become the light by itself, tatha idam